Okay. The course is just two lanes, inside, outside. Up at the pontoon barge up there, we're going to hold your sterns. And as the clock is good, we're going to release you. You're just going to drag race down to the finish. Stay in your lane. If you do not stay in your lane, you're going to get disqualified. You finish between the buoy and the shore and the pontoon and the buoy.
Mary Schlimmer and Holly Reynolds was the first team registered, so come on up. You're going to draw the first number for us. That first number is 22. 22, that's where you guys will be. And looking at our first heat here, that outside lane will be Gloria Wesley and Zach Keene. And on the inside lane will be Kevin and Rick Olson. The flag is up. And we're underway. They are paddling hard. This is our very first heat. In that outside lane, it's Gloria Wesley and Zach Keene, Kevin and Rick Olson on the inside. Looking to move on to round two, the 2015-4 Dash. Looks like about a new length lead for Wesley and Keene on that outside lane. Here they come, we're on to the finish line. Looks like pulling out in the first heat. That outside lane, Gloria Wesley and Zach Keene. Flag is up. And they're off. Paddling hard from just behind the other strokes over there. And that outside lane is Drew Capo and John Webb. Inside lane is Terry Montgomery and Neil Weisner Hanks. Looking to move on to round two. The 2015 Dash for Dash. Towards the finish line, here they come. Looks like in that outside lane, going to take the checkered flag and move on to the next round. Drew Capo and John Webb over Terry Montgomery and Neil Weisner Hanks will be moving on to the next round. Kevin Hard towards the finish line. Move on to round two. Survive in advance. Just like in the NCAA tournament. Here they come. In that outside lane, it's Nick Walton and Christoph Brew. Inside lane, Rick Jillings and Susan Williams. And Susan Williams in the round two of the 2015 AuSable River Canoe Marathon. Dash for dash. Walton and Brew will get their times for you. Jillings and Williams come across the line. Big hand for them too. Paddling hard. Flag is up. They're underway. Paddling hard towards the finish line in round two. The 2015 Dash for Dash. Again in the outside lanes. Patrick Madden and Roger Henry. The inside lane. Tom Holloway and Jim Heller. Both teams paddling hard right at the buoy. The checkered flag to move on to round two over Patrick Madden and Roger Henry. Hellerin's moving on to face Walton and Crewman and Simon Pierre Lacombe. Here they come. Pierre Lacombe with a slight lead over Lucien Sonaro. Here they come to the finish line. And indeed, moving on to round two will be Pascal Lafrand and Simon Pierre Lacombe over John Lucy and Joe Sonaro. Good runs for both. And the paddlers are underway. Looking to move into round two of the 2015-4 dash. If you're into the sound of my voice, come on out. The finish line park and catch all the excitement from the dash for dash. That outside lane, it is Tim Sheldon and Sylvie Andrew. Inside lane, Gary Abria and Peter Dunn. The Consumers Energy Pontoon Checker Flag. Here they come to the finish line. And taking that checker flag, moving on to round two, Tim Sheldon and Sylvie Andrew over Gary Abria and Peter Heed. And he's scared.
Wow, and it looks like Walton and crew will move on to the...
Captain Hart as they go to that second buoy. The elite eight. Boy, it's a close one at that second buoy. Home as they come toward the finish line. Another fast time coming in here. Yes, moving on to the elite eight in round three. Will be Pascal Lambron and Simon Bierwe. Both teams with very similar times in that first round. I think it's going to be another tight one.
One of these two teams will move into the final. Flag is up. And we are racing.
final teams on the Consumers Energy 2015-4 Cash. It's Walton and Prue on the outside, Lampron and McComb on the inside. All teams paddling hard to make it. Outside. Howard and Blay on the inside. One of those two teams are going to claim the championship.